We have looked at converting some JavaScript types when we studied variables, and we looked at changing the type of a variable. And now let's look more formally at JavaScript type conversions. There are two different types of type conversions. There's an explicit conversion and an implicit conversion, and that's what we're going to cover in this video. The explicit conversion is when the conversion is specifically called to change the type. Let's look at an example of explicitly changing the type. If we want to explicitly change something to a number, we can call the number function and pass in anything we want. In this case, I'm passing in a string. It's a string because it's in quotation marks. And by calling the number function, I can convert that string to a number. That number returned is 599. It sees that string only contains digits and a decimal point, so it knows how to convert that to a number and returns that number. We can also store that in a variable. So we can say some number is assigned the conversion to a number of the value 599. And so now if we look at what's in some number, we can see that 599 is stored into some number. Because we're using a function, we're specifically telling JavaScript to do a conversion, and the conversion that we're asking it to do is to number by using the number function. In this video, we're going to study three different explicit conversion calls: number, string, and Boolean. And they're exactly the same names as the types, but you have to make sure you capitalize that first letter so they're really easy to remember. Note there are additional functions that will explicitly convert from one type to another type, and we're just going to take a look at these three for this video. Let's look at some explicit conversion examples. Let's say we want to create a variable, my dog age, and assign that to the number that is converting the string with the character 3 in it. Well, we know that 3 is a digit, and so JavaScript can convert that 3 to a number. And so now my dog age has a 3 in it. Well, it doesn't make a lot of sense when you're using literals to do that conversion. I mean, I could have just said my dog age equals 3. You know, why did I put it in a string in the first place? Well, if we remember, prompt returns a string. So if I want to prompt what is the age of my dog, in order to get that value, that is going to return a string. See how it's in quotation marks? So if we want to convert that string to a number, because maybe we want to do some calculations with it, maybe we want to say how many years that is in human years, we need a number. So we can explicitly convert that to a number, and we can call the prompt right inside that number function. Now see how we have an opening parenthesis and a closing parenthesis that are outer parentheses. So that means everything inside those parentheses, that's the parameter for number. So what are we going to convert to a number? Well, the result of the prompt. Well, what is the result of the prompt? Well, whatever we typed in as a string. So we're going to take that string that was typed in and convert that to a number. So now when I ask what's the age of my dog, I put in the 3, and that 3 is returned as a string and then converted to a number, giving us the 3 back. So we can explicitly convert whatever was in the prompt to a number when we're expecting a number. Let's look at another example. I want to create a variable to store the day of my birth. And I was born on the 5th. And I want to convert that 5 to a string. Now in my birthday, I have the string 5. We also have a function that will convert to Boolean. So I could just type in the Boolean function, pass it in a string of a value, and that's going to give me a result. In this case, it converted the string true to true. And we're going to learn about those rules of conversion in the upcoming videos. The other type of conversion is an implicit conversion, and that's when JavaScript does the conversion automatically. That implicit conversion is performed by JavaScript in order to make the operation possible. Let's look at an example. If we want to divide the string 99 by 100, what are we really wanting to do? Well, likely we want to convert that 99 to a number, so then we can actually do the division. Although we assume that 99 makes sense as a number and it can be divided by 100, JavaScript actually has to go through the process of converting that string to a number before it can do the division. So that's when the implicit conversion occurs. We can't divide a string, so that string gets converted to a number in order for the operation to be successful. And therefore, we get the expected answer of 0.99 when we divide 99 by 100. Let's look at a more complex example. Here we're using variables, then we're going to do a multiplication and a division. We have a variable price that's set to the string of 100.00. We have a variable discount, and it is set to the string of 10. We have a variable of discount amount, and we're going to set that equal to the price multiplied by the discount divided by 100. Well, let's think about what's going to happen here. What is the first operation that JavaScript will do? Well, we have our order of precedence. So these are all multiplication and division. So those have the same order of precedence. But what comes before our operators? Well, any parentheses. If anything is in parentheses, we want to look at evaluating that first. So the first thing that it's going to do is divide discount by 100. Well, discount is the string 10, and we can divide the string 10 only by converting that string 10 to a number. So it's going to implicitly convert that string 10 to the number 10 in order to be able to do the division. We're going to end up with 10 divided by 100, which gives us 0.1. So now this part of the equation has evaluated to 0.1, and that 0.1 is a number now, but we're going to be multiplying that by the price, which is a string. Well, the computer can't multiply strings, so it will check if it can convert that price to a number. Well, price is all digits in a decimal place, so it can convert that. So it's going to multiply that 100 times 0.1 and give us the answer of 10. That answer 10 is going to be stored into our discount amount variable. So we can think about that as 3 different steps, where first our discount is going to be divided by 100, and it does that implicit conversion. The next step is going to be the multiplication, and it doesn't know how to multiply a string, so it again does that implicit conversion. And then the last step is assigning that value that's the result of the expression into the discount amount. When we execute that code, it all appears to happen in one step, but if we think through the process, it's actually going step by step and doing the different evaluations until it comes up with the correct answer to store into the discount amount. So there's two types of conversion, explicit and implicit. And the explicit is when we specifically call a function to say, do the conversion. And the implicit is when it does the conversion based on the operation. Now we can always choose to do explicit conversion. So we could have said, instead of assuming that JavaScript is going to do the conversion of the price, we could explicitly call the function number to convert that price to a number before it is operated on. And also, the discount was the string, so we can explicitly call number on the discount so that we'll also be converted to a number prior to the division. So here we have changed the implicit conversions to explicit conversions by calling the functions prior to the multiplication and the division, and we end up with the same answer.